Hello friends, in this video we will see the databases, how to manage the databases using the NetBeans IDE, which is the management of database is available in the services window. If you recall, there is a services window which is available or which appears in the explorer part of your NetBeans IDE, and in which all the runtime resources that are available to for you to use in your NetBeans application or NetBeans project that are displayed there. One of them is a databases node. If you expand the databases node, you show the different database servers that are installed in the machine. It will also show the JDBC drivers that are installed in the machine and that are available for you in the NetBeans. And it will also show the connections, either connected or disconnected connections right now. That will also be visible there. If you choose any of the servers, for example MySQL server or JavaDB server, the Derby server, Derby is incidentally packaged along with the NetBeans IDE itself. When you install NetBeans, the Derby is also installed. So if you choose that, right click, there is a start option. You can start the MySQL server. As soon as you start, below the server node, you will find a list of all the databases that have been created under the MySQL server. You can choose a particular database and say connect. So the connection will be displayed under the connections category. Okay, choose that and expand that, you will find the list of tables, views, procedures, etc. Choose the tables. Okay, expand that, you will find the different tables that are created under that particular database. If you want to have a look at the data pertaining to a particular table, choose it, right click and ask view data. So the data will be displayed. Data will be displayed in the typical Excel sheet like structure. But incidentally, the window that will appear in the documents window will have two parts. One will be the Excel like structure, rows and columns. The columns will have the names of the fields that you have created or rather given when table is created. And the above part of that window will be a SQL window, wherein you can write an SQL query. SQL query you can write and you can execute that query. So that the result of that SQL query will be incorporated into the table. So there are two options. One, you can do the operations like insert, edit, delete, etc. using the Visual Designer. You can also run SQL queries and perform the modifications on the data which is inside the table by running the SQL queries. Actually the SQL queries can also be run. The JDBC drivers that are available, you can use that JDBC driver, any of them, and what type of drivers incidentally you will see. If you have installed JavaDB servers or JavaDB drivers will always be there because they are installed when NetBeans is installed. If you have installed MySQL, MySQL drivers, usually MySQL driver is provided by the MySQL server itself, MySQL org itself. So MySQL / J, connector / J, that is the name of the driver that will be visible in the JDBC drivers list. Oracle drivers are also generally found by default in the NetBeans IDE, and PostgreSQL driver is also present. Okay, use any of these drivers to establish a connection with a database. So there are two possibilities. One is start the server and from the drop down choose a particular database and establish the connection. Or using the driver, connect using and establish a connection with a particular driver. Okay, you can also add a new driver from the drivers node. On the drivers node, if you right click, it will ask you to add a new driver. Okay, so all these functionalities can help you manage the database from within the NetBeans. Okay, you don't have to go to the manager console of that particular type of database server itself. You can do it from the NetBeans itself. Okay. So what I will do now is I will show all the operations. First I will choose the JavaDB. Okay. Start the JavaDB, open the sample connection and see the data that is pertaining to the to a particular table in the sample database. Then I will choose the MySQL server, start MySQL server, choose a particular database and see the list of the tables, create a table. One of the options on the table and right click, there will be a create table. So a table designer will appear, okay, wherein you can name the columns, their type, their width, etc. The table will be created and then you can insert the data either by running SQL query or by using the designer. Okay. Then I will show you how to install a driver. For example, SQLite driver, JDBC driver you want to install. The procedure of that also I will show you. Using the SQLite driver, I will create a database in which I will create a table and so on. So all these activities I will show you by different practical demonstrations.
I will now show you how to manage the databases that are available to our NetBeans IDE using the databases node in the services window. In the databases node, if you expand this, it will show you the different database servers that are currently installed in this computer. It will also show you the list of drivers, JDBC drivers that have been installed and they can be used along with the NetBeans IDE for the JDBC connectivity purpose. And it will also show you the connection objects or the connections that have been created and what is the status of those connections. For example, this connection JDBC Derby at localhost 1527 sample. It is a disconnected connection right now. Okay. So this is what you see when you expand the databases node. First of all, this MySQL server, which is by default, you know, listening to the port number 3306 and which is currently disconnected, you can start the server. And it will show you the different databases that are currently available on that MySQL server. Out of which, suppose if I want to use this test database, you will say connect. You will have to give the privileges of username and password. There is no password set for this MySQL database in my computer, so I will not give any password. Connection is established, it will say, and you will also see the connection created here. You see the difference between these two symbols. This is a disconnected one, this is a connected one. Expand on this, it will show you the test database which is being connected right now. If you expand on this, it will show you the tables. There are no tables right now in this. Later on, we shall see how to create the table also. So this is how you can connect with the MySQL database. Okay. Disconnect the connection here. And even delete the connection. Okay, so this is how you can establish a MySQL connection. Next is this JavaDB, the Derby database that is, you know, made available to you along with this NetBeans IDE. So this JavaDB, that means the Java Derby database, if you want to connect to the server, you say start. The Java DB database process will show you that it is being started now. If you expand on this, there is a sample database which is already available in this Derby package. You can, in fact, the connection is already here. You can connect it from here. The sample database is being connected to. You see the connection, the symbol changes to the connected symbol. Click on this. We show you the tables. These are the different tables that are already created in this sample database. If you want to have a look at the data that is presently available in this customer table, for instance, right click and you say view data. This is the view of the data. These are the different fields or columns. You can even find out the database structure from this. Just put the cursor on any of these fields and it will show you the name of the field, type, length, etc. This data is extracted as a result of this SQL command, select star from, etc. So this is the SQL view. This is the, you know, visual representation of the table. Okay, so this is how you can create or you can connect to the sample database. If you want to create your own database in addition to the sample, just right click on this, you will get a create database option. You can create a new database in which you can create a new table and fill up the data, etc. If you want to create a new table, for instance, in this sample database of the Java DB server, just put a cursor on this, right click, create table. A table designer will appear in front of you. Just say add column. Before that, just give a suitable name. I will say my table. And then say add column, name, and just say name. Okay, the data type I want. Varchar, size 10. Okay. Another column, I will say marks, I will say small int, okay, the table is created. You should see the entry of that table here, my table. Then you click on this and in order to add the data, if you just say view data, it will not show anything. From this visual appearance here, you will find an insert record. You can insert one record here, name, marks, This is the new record that is created. You can also give a insert query, insert into my table values some other name, some other value, and just say run the SQL. If you again now view the data, you should find second record being added here. So that's how you can add the create the table and add the data in any table. Okay, so this is how you can use the Java DB or Derby database along with your NetBeans. Now expand on this drivers sub node under the databases node. You click on this plus, we show you the different JDBC drivers that have been currently installed in this machine. You can see that the Java DB drivers embedded and network JDBC drivers are present. The MySQL JDBC driver called as connector/j is also installed. Oracle OCI, OCI stands for Oracle Call Interface, which is a type 2 driver, and Oracle Thin JDBC driver, which is a type 4 and system independent driver, that is also installed in this machine. And then there is a PostgreSQL JDBC driver is also present. So you can use these drivers to establish the connection and create new database as if you want. For instance, if I click on this and say connect using, this is the port number on which the default 3306 is the port on which MySQL server listens. Just say finish. The connection is established. If you expand on this, this is a MySQL database, and these are the other databases that are currently available in the MySQL server. You can use any of them, add table, view the data, run different SQL statements that we have just seen. Okay, so this is how the drivers node can be seen. Now you can also install a new driver by right click on this, it will say new driver. Now we shall install a new driver. Let us say SQLite driver we will install, and then we will create a SQL database as SQLite database as well. Now next I will show you how to install the SQLite JDBC driver. So for that purpose, first you have to get the SQLite JDBC driver jar file downloaded from its URL where that has been hosted. I have already done that. I will show you the URL from which I have downloaded the SQLite JDBC jar. This is the place from which you can obtain the SQLite JDBC jar files. It is bitbucket.org xerial SQLite JDBC downloads. This is the entire URL onto which you can find the different versions of the SQLite JDBC drivers. You can get hold of an appropriate jar file and download it into your computer first, and then use it for doing all the activities like creating a database and adding the table, etc. So first get hold of the jar file from this page. Now go to the driver node, right click, new driver, say add, browse to the file that you have downloaded, SQLite JDBC 3.15.jar. Click on this open. The name that is automatically chosen is SQLite. You can change if you want, and click on OK. So this is the SQLite JDBC driver that is appearing in the drivers collection. Okay. Now use this SQLite JDBC driver to establish the connection and create a new database. Right click on this, say connect using, give the JDBC URL, I'll say test. The test is the name of the database that is to be created. Right, so JDBC SQL test is created, the connection is established. Expand on this node, tables there are none, views, procedures, also this being a new database, there is nothing into it. As we have seen before, you can right click and create a table. The table designer will appear, give the name of the table, the add the columns and so on, and then you can also add the data into it. So that is the procedure that we have already seen. Exactly the same procedure can also be used for a SQLite database, SQLite table also. Okay, so that is the demonstration of the database management using the NetBeans IDE.